Today is Knit in Public Day, so I thought it'd be great to come to the Frontier Cultural Museum with my knitting bag and my husband, who's off camera, and do a little knitting today. So we'll hope to have a clip here in just a bit. We are currently in the Irish 1750 house with one of the spinners, and she is working on some wool that she's spun to, that she's trying to build up some to do some dyeing, some natural dyeing later in the year. And I'm about to do some knitting. And
hello. Hi. Do you want to come up here for a second? No, you're going to take my yarn though. There we go. We have been adoring your little white cats.
Yes, we've been a feral litter this winter.
Ah.
So the museum adopted them. They're our new farm cats, so we're hoping they'll control the mice population.
Yeah. Earn their keep.
Well, and they're so unique to be pretty much entirely white.
I was told by a school child that, fun fact, that apparently the white gene is dominant and the mother was white.
Okay. Now we have a demonstration of using the walking wheel, which is much better than if I'm trying to do a demonstration of it, because she is clearly much, much more skilled than I am on this wheel. So what your wheel, do you know what time frame that wheel specific, or is it?
I've seen a lot of sketches and paintings of wheels, different kinds. I've seen mm-hmm. ones that look like this. Our curator here at Frontier Cultural Museum feels that this is an acceptable kind of wheel that some people had.
They have. Mm-hmm. Mine, I know mine is a 1860 wheel. And this is a little different. The wheel itself is a little smaller and more compact. Mm-hmm. You know, the design is the same. I would imagine it was, you know, whatever they had as their skill and availability.
Absolutely.
But I love the spindle on yours.
Yeah, this wheel, people that work here and spin on this one, we usually have to make sure our wool is fairly clean. You don't want too much lanolin left in it. You want the wool to be brushed thoroughly, because this spindle is held in place by the little leather straps and pegs.
Yes.
And the mother of all that holds the spindle is on the neck of the wheel, and it will turn and get out of alignment if you pull too hard. So you cannot, when you're drafting out, you can't pull but so hard.
That's some of the problem I have with mine. I need to repair one of the leather pieces holding the spindle in place. And there you have it. But this is a really good example how you draft out. Put in a lot of extra twist. And then.
But some of this yarn, if we need a thicker yarn for a knitting project, we can always ply it.
Yes. There we go. Excellent. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Interesting.
A little Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner.
Okay.
So this is a mountain dulcimer. It's a uniquely Appalachian Blue Ridge instrument. And its predecessors are some German instruments, some Irish instruments, the Scheitholz and the Zephyr one. But basically, it's a very customizable instrument. A lot of people are making their own when they wanted to have one. So mine at home looks very different to this one, but it's the same sort of thing. You've got all the strings at the top, and you can hold down mostly just the first one, and play it. Mine at home has 5 strings and a very different looking body. It's more like a violin, whereas this one is more oblong, and sometimes they're really long trapezoids and stuff. It just depends on how good the person making it was. But basically, you start off with 3 basic strings, the wound string, which is the bass, the harmony string, and the melody string. And you can tune it really however you like. There's like 10 million different ways you can tune it, and there's no standardized tuning. There's also no standardized musical notation, so you can imagine how much fun that is. But basically, you play it top down, and you have your fingers holding down different things. So you play it a lot like you would a banjo in terms of fingering. Now, I don't play the guitar. I play the banjo, so you can probably do all these things on the guitar. But to me, it's banjo. So lots of hammer-ons, hammer-offs, slides, things like that. I was actually working on something a bit beyond my ability, but that's fun, you know? I brought 3 alto recorder songs and 3 songs for the dulcimer to play, but I'll play one for you that I'm actually quite good at. I say quite, but I know my fingers will betray me. Sometimes I think George Bowman, who the builder of this house, he doesn't like when I play songs too often because all of a sudden it will go out of tune or I won't be able to hold down a string well anymore. He's like, please stop. Just stop playing. Is called O wie wohl ist mir am Abend. It's by Carl Friedrich Schulz, who was popular in the early part of the 19th century, so in this 1820s house. This would have been a song that this family would have known. Unfortunately, most of the notation you find is all in English, but it's really like a very nice, beautiful song. And you can kind of see, if you're a music person, you can see they have notation for the DAD tuning, which is what I use, and DAA. Those are the 2 most popular tunings. But there's one called Dorian tuning that is very interesting to me because I have this finger picking song to do, and I have 2 other versions, and one uses Dorian tuning, which is in like a minor key. I'm entirely self-taught, so I don't know anything about music. I kind of just look at the little notes and I'm like, yeah, that's a thing. But yeah, that's what I'm doing. What would you like me to play, though?
Play anything.
Anything, yeah.
Just, I can't think of anything. I'll just play some random notes. I can play an actual song, but it's not appropriate for this house. Let's see if I remember it. Yeah, I can't do it, but I can play the Skye Boat song.
Thank you. Yeah.